Land, soil, water, natural vegetation and wildlife. Geography lesson 2. Video part 2. In this session, we will discuss natural vegetation and wildlife. Natural vegetation and wildlife exist only in the narrow zone of contact between the lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere that we call biosphere. Natural vegetation and wildlife exist only in the biosphere. In the biosphere, living beings are interrelated and interdependent on each other for their survival. This life supporting system is known as ecosystem. Ecosystem is a life supporting system in which living beings are interrelated and interdependent on each other for their survival. Vegetation and wildlife are valuable resources. There are innumerable uses of plants. Plants provide us with timber, shelter to animals, produce oxygen, protect soil for growing crops, act as a shelter belts, give us fruits and vegetables, help in storage of underground water, etc. Wildlife includes animals, birds, insects, as well as the aquatic life forms. They provide us milk, meat, hides and wool. They help in pollination of flowers, act as a decomposers in the ecosystem. So animals, big or small, all are integral to maintaining the balance in the ecosystem. Natural vegetation is a renewable resource, but its judicial use is must. If it is not used in a proper manner, it can lead to the loss of life and furthermore calamities. Distribution of natural vegetation. The growth of vegetation depends primarily on temperature and moisture. The major vegetation types of the world are grouped as forest, grasslands, scrubs and tundra. Natural vegetation can be classified into evergreen forest and deciduous forest. Trees of evergreen forest do not shed their leaves simultaneously in any season of the year. So in evergreen forest, trees do not shed their leaves simultaneously in any season of the year. In deciduous forest, trees shed their leaves in a particular season to conserve loss of moisture through transpiration. In dry areas, thorny scrubs grow in low rainfall areas. In areas of heavy rainfall, huge trees, dry forests are thus associated with the areas having abundant water supply. Conservation of natural vegetation and wildlife. Forests are our wealth. Changes in the climate condition and human interference can cause the loss of natural habitation of the plants and animals. Deforestation, soil erosion, construction activities, forest fires, tsunami, landslides, etc. are some of the human and natural factors that accelerate the process of extinction of these resources. Many species have come endangered and some are on the verge of extinction. Poaching is one of the major concerns which results in the sharp decline in the number of particular species. The animals are poached The animals are hunted for collection and illegal trade of hides, skins, nails, teeth, horns, and feathers. Due to the indiscriminate killings, several birds and animals have either become extinct or are on the verge of extinction. There is a balance in the environment if the relative number of species is not disturbed. How we can conserve this natural vegetation and wildlife? National parks, wildlife sanctuaries, biosphere reserves are made to protect our natural vegetation and wildlife. Conservation of creeks, lakes, and wetlands is necessary to save the precious resources from depletion. Awareness programs like social forestry, Vanam Mahotsava are also established at regional and community level. The school children are also encouraged to watch the nature and conducting nature camps so that they appreciate the habitat of varied species. It is our ethical duty to conserve plants and animals. Many countries have passed laws declaring that the trade as well as killing of birds and animals are illegal. Under Article 48 of the Indian Constitution, forest conservation has made a directive principle. Conservation of plants, animals is an ethical duty of every citizen.